SP Muddahanumegowda.
Sir, thank you, sir.
Namak.
Sir, I may kindly be permitted to speak from this place, sir.
I will come.
Sir, once again, at the cost of repetition.
Can you speak with Gowda?
Just, I would like to subscribe my views, sir.
Yes.
To the views expressed by my senior colleague, Sri Premchandranji, with regard to the necessity of promulgating the ordinance with regard to this amendment, sir. Sir, the word ordinance has got seriousness. In Kannada, we use the word Sugrivagne. That shows the seriousness of the word. In the rarest of the rare cases, we do adopt the measure of bringing legislation through ordinances. But here, I request the Honorable Law Minister, who himself is a legal luminary, to convince us, to explain this house and to let the country know what is that imminent urgency you had in bringing this legislation through the mode of adopting the ordinance. Because unless and even the other bill which is coming today, the sports bill, that is also in the, you have adopted the mode of ordinance. That's why the seriousness of that bit will definitely, it will be erased if it is repeatedly, unnecessarily used. So that's why, and I raise my reservation with regard to that, sir. And then, sir, the main reason assigned by you in the statement of objection reason is to attract business at international level. That is the word you have used. And also to ease up doing business and speedy settlement of commercial disputes is the other reasons you have assigned to bring this legislation. Sir, if your intention is to see that at the global scenario, you want to attract business at the international level, then why you have reduced the quantum of the money from 1 crore to 3 lakhs? Sir, if you see section 2C, nearly 22 items are mentioned. Almost every alternative litigation which is pending in the civil courts must be a commercial dispute. A commercial dispute which transaction, ordinary transaction of merchants, bankers, financiers, traders, etc., etc. So if that is the case, when you are bringing a special legislation to forum commercial courts, then it should have some seriousness. Sir, here, you have already in the morning itself, you have fairly conceded about the pendency of litigation in this country, including the civil and criminal cases. Sir, here, by reducing the quantum of 1 crore to 3 lakhs to bring within the ambit of this legislation, then once again it loses its importance. Because this is a special act, you are forming commercial courts, specifically with an intention to see that at the global scenario, to attract business at the international level, you would like to bring this legislation. So, my observation is that bringing that, by reducing the quantum of the final pecuniary jurisdiction, reducing the quantum of pecuniary jurisdiction 3 lakhs, I think it takes away the seriousness of this legislation. That is my observation. Sir, okay, it's all right. Your intention is to ease out the business, doing business, and also speedy settlement of the commercial disputes. If that is the say, then what is the measure you have taken, you have initiated under this act only, to create more courts, to create more infrastructure, and to see speedy disposal of the cases requires an abundant infrastructure. If you want to do the dispose of the cases, even commercial cases, in the same infrastructure, I don't think your purpose will be served. Sir, in the morning, for your own answer, what we could infer is, even the matters, criminal cases, where the punishment is up for about 3 years, there are many cases, many instances, where they are under trial prisoners for more than 4 or 5 years. Because of lack of infra and because of the speedy disposal of the cases, even the prisoners are also lying in the prisons and they are serving more period than what is the punishment that has been prescribed in the act. That is the case. Forget about the fate of the civil litigants. Civil litigants also, in fact, for 20 years, 25, 30 years, we have been seeing cases, cases which are lingering and cases which are pending in all the civil courts. If that is the case, under the same situation, in the same situation, how can you get the matters disposed of speedily without making any provision with regard to creation of additional infrastructure? Here in the entire act, we are not seeing any additional provision for creation of additional infrastructure. For example, sir, in the Commercial Appellate Division Court, you are appointing a High Court judge. You are appointing a High Court judge, sitting High Court judge. That's what the act says. The state government shall, with the concurrence of the Chief Justice of High Court, appoint one or more persons having experience in dealing with commercial disputes to be the judges, judge or judges of a commercial court from amongst the cadre of higher judicial services. Likewise, the Chief Justice of the High Court nominate such judges of the High Court who have experience in dealing with commercial disputes to be the judges of the Commercial Appellate Division. So you are trying to extract manpower from the manpower which is already working and the manpower which is overburdened, resulting in the enormous, inordinate delay in disposal of both civil, criminal and other matters. So if that is the case, sir, unless you create more infrastructure, unless you appoint more judges, if you do not ease out, if you cannot ease out the burden of the sitting judges, both in the subordinate judiciary and as well as the higher judiciary, then the purpose of bringing this legislation will not be meted out. That is the situation. Sir, why I am mentioning is, in the morning itself, now itself, you have fairly considered
conclude
that more than 5,000 subordinate judicial officers, there is shortage of more than 5,500 subordinate judicial officers. And nearly 50% of high court judges, there are vacancies of 50% of the high court judges. If that is the case, then sir, unless more judges are appointed, more courts are created, more infrastructure is created, the very purpose of bringing this legislation will be defeated. Sir, within 2 minutes I will complete, sir.
Sir,
you are bringing this pre-meditation and settlement, pre-institution mediation and settlement. This is a new chapter you are bringing. What is the purpose you are serving by bringing this list? Sir, you want to create authorities under the Legal Services Authorities Act for pre-mediation and settlement. And you are making a mandatory pre-mediation and settlement. Every case, whether even if it is a matter of 3 lakhs, then it should be referred to under this provision. And there is also a provision created for a litigant. Wisely, to avoid this provision, if he makes an application, interim application, then the matter is taken away from this provision. If any interim application is there, seeking any order of injunction or some order, then that matter is being taken away from this provision. Mere filing of the application is sufficient. Or otherwise, where is the provision? Who is going to decide whether this is a case that should be referred to the pre-institution of mediation and settlement, or it should not be referred like that? Because unless there is a provision, every person who wants to be here, they can save five months of time. That's why anybody can file an interim application and file a petition before the court, commercial court, and avoid this provision. There
please,
is absolutely, there is
please,
scope for that.
Please conclude.
Sir, in
please,
1 minute, I'll conclude,
please,
sir. Sir, finally, I would like to bring a problem of my own state, sir. Sir, in the morning, my leader, Sri Mallikarjun Khargeji, raised a very important pertinent note, which has been making very big news in our state. Sir, this House, August House, was kind enough to give special status to Hyderabad, Karnataka under Article 371J of the Constitution. That provision was given, see, keeping in mind the backwardness of that area. And 6 districts are included. Gulbarga, Bidar, Yadgir, Raichur, Bellary and Koppal, they come under this Hyderabad, Karnataka. Article 371J was awarded, a special status was awarded under that provision, keeping the fact that the area requires further development. And fortunately, a bench was also created there at Gulbarga. 3 branches are created in Karnataka. One is in Bangalore, second one is in Hubli Dharwad, and third one is in Gulbarga. Sir, if Article 371 benefit is to be given to all these 6 districts, that should be geographically also, that should be kept intact. Because any disputes, what has happened, sir, here out of the 6 districts, 2 districts are taken away from the jurisdiction of territorial jurisdiction of this court, and they are given to High Court at Hubli Dharwad. Sir, suppose a litigation is filed with regard to the provisions of Article 371J at Hubli Dharwad, any order that is going to be passed there, that affects the whole 370 at Hyderabad Karnataka area. That's why my humble request is, sir, that kindly from your side, sir, from the Government of India side, please see that these 2 districts also be kept intact in the territorial jurisdiction of this Gulbarga High Court, so as to see the real meaning of this Hyderabad Karnataka and the special status that has been given to under Article 371J should be given there, sir. Sir, with these words, sir, with these observations, sir, I conclude.
Thank you
for the opportunity.
JJT Netaji.